is Right Here Waiting by Richard Marx. Singer, songwriter, he recorded, well, released a song in 1989. It was written about his then girlfriend, later his wife, Cynthia, who was out for a movie, I think, as in she was an actress. He was touring and he was missing her like crazy. This song was the result of it and it became a huge hit, probably his biggest of his whole, very impressive career, I have to say. Now, as you could have seen, two ways of playing it, well, two ways that I'm going to teach it, let's put it that way. The strumming one is actually how he, well, mostly does by himself. Sometimes accompanied maybe by another guitar player or by strings or an orchestra or whatever, but usually, very often, I've seen it just playing on the guitar, just strumming his way through the song there. So, what we have then is the key of C. He sometimes tunes his guitar a half step down nowadays, which I can imagine. It's quite high, even though he sings quite high. So, we have chords 1, 4, 5, the three major chords, C with a low G there on the bottom. That's how he, in particular, does it. Then for F, more like an F sus2, leaving the third string open. So for that, wrap your thumb around the neck to catch the low F there in the bass. Then for G, he pretty much just plays it like this, not even using his middle finger there, throwing in a sus4 with his index there. He plays a lot with hammer-ons, I have to say, with all those chords. Also for A minor, two minor chords in the song, yes, A minor chord 6, and then D minor, also a hammer-on for that one. And I think that is it throughout the song. Well, a G with a B in the bass, a C with an E in the bass, but yes, that is it. So not too much happening for that. What he does do is, you know, make it a bit more interesting by using right hand techniques, using palm muting, dampening the strings there, sometimes a lot, sometimes a little less, sometimes he just strums full on there and so on, kind of to just build up the song, you know, up, down, to change it dynamically here and there. We'll go through those details as well. Now, of course, the song has a beautiful melody. I'm sure you will agree with me. So it is really nice to, well, to play it, and to indeed play it as a some kind of a chord, so at least the intro. That's what I would like to do. Play the intro, incorporate all those melody notes, and then just keep picking when you start singing there. So we'll at least thoroughly break down the intro, and then for the rest of the song, how you want to pick it could be in a couple of ways, but I'll show you a couple of things that you can do for it. So, a relatively easy song, depending on which version you're going for. You will find out with the chord melody thing, it is less easy than you might think. There are fingers moving, and it's hard to move a finger and to not do anything with another one. So you move one, and then you need to move another one, and move another one. I will get into details about that definitely for sure. You have to have good hand positioning there as well. So for one version, this hand has quite a bit of technique. For the other one, the strumming one, the technique is more in the strumming hand for that matter. Anyway, so all that will be in the lesson, and you can check it out at totallyguitars.com.